close range here. That's my goal. My goal may not be to take the knife away, but my goal from here is to control. Attack, and then I gotta do my double control here. So I have to have two hands, one and one, always. As soon as I go from this to this, boom. And then I can begin to attack. My arm stays straight a lot. If I stay like this, if I'm a smaller, bigger person, slash. He can come back towards me. If I'm here, slash. It's much more difficult. So my arms get locked up. So here, one, two. So notice the movement. What we do at the beginning of class. Bam. Knife. Pushing away, shoulder low, shoulder high. Pa. Or bump. If I can hit the shoulder, I get a very strong punch to the face. That's my range. If I turn like this, I can't reach, I can't touch the shoulder. So your checkpoint will be, can I hit here? If I can, but I can tap pretty good, I'm at very close range, I'm good. So again, knife is close, I grab. Strong seekers, my thumb is down. Pushing, not this way, but I push this way. Attack, grab, kick, a few times. One option. He wants a knife, I give it back to him. For his chest. It's always good. And legally, the nice thing is, my fingerprints are hard on the knife. Nice. So right now, you guys, working on grabbing, pushing away, attacking one, and control. My feet begin to move outside that channel. From here, lock your arms up straight, kick. This now, it's okay to bring the feet back, but to maintain control. Boom. Boom. He's had enough, I can separate. Here, I still feel some resistance. Boom! I drive my body to the knife. One option. You disarm. You law enforcement handcuffed from this position. So there's many ways that I'm in control once I have this. But it all starts here with this. Tonight, one, two, three. Kick.